the day, Karla had this thing called poetic rehab. Yes. And it was a beautiful thing. And we all had to start our pieces saying, I get high when I write. It's supposed to be a confessional for writers. So this is what I wrote. I don't think I need this. I get high when I write. These words take me up and over the never-ending streamline of obligations, altercations, hemming up my imagination in the effort to make the rawness of my inside seem clean. See, there's so much more to me than sitting inside of inner conditioning under fluorescent lighting, spending half of my lifetime in a cubicle, head bobbing to the staccato of my fingers typing to help my bosses get richer. I wish I could spend more time writing about the beauty of butterfly wings erupting through chrysalis, how it felt to grow my hair out after trimming away the processed edges, how almost 10 years later I've gone natural and a completely different person, how much I've missed my grandmother, I see her face in mine after she passed, how the breast cancer took her and my anger at God still hasn't passed, how the wedding dress still hangs lonely in the closet untouched, how I hate myself for the times I love the wrong people too much and not myself enough. And then there's the torture of knowing the love you once had will never be what you once imagined, and the heartbreak. If I could just write about how many times I lay awake wondering how much more I can take, I'm looking at the man in the mirror. Over my shoulders, tears straining to break through. I can't expose these shards of these emotions to you. How that now that you're gone, even my praise doesn't sound the same. How I hear your voice when I praise God's name. And good Lord, I'm tired of Christian brothers. Where y'all at? Knowing how to spit scriptures until they get you caught up in their covers. Then it's over before it even started. Listen, men with biblical names all treat you the same. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, especially James. Got Christ on his lips, but Satan sitting on his tongue as he sweetly spits his game, leaving a bitter taste in his mouth with the women that they break by telling the same story five different ways. But wait! I write this for little black girls bullied on school buses, coming home crying because someone told them they were too ugly to be loved, and little sister, you're beautiful. They just fear what they refuse to see. You're the most precious thing on earth. You are divinity. I write this for outcast artists shamed for being different. I do this for the church hurt. One day the pain will be lifted. These words are describing the actions of just a fraction of what happened to inspire me to keep writing, so those who lay in bed questioning their life in isolation can hear something similar and know that God heard them and their life is still worth living. Most of y'all go to church, right? Y'all know kind of what it's like. Can we all just touch and agree that if the spoken word created life and life more abundantly, if it created universes, moved mountains, stirred stars, how much more can it do for the broken and the scarred? How much more when it's directed to those who are hurting and willing to die? These words are healers, deliverance in plain sight. This is emancipation. Grab these words and take flight. This is salvation. I say it because poetry changed my life. I take this seriously because spoken words saved my life. I've seen people get healed and delivered at open mics. So grab your own notebooks and your own pens. Prepare to change your life. Thank you.